नंदात्मजा रसिका शेखा स्वयं भगवान कृष्ण एकले ईश्वर अद्वितीय नंदात्मजा रसिका शेखर स्वयं भगवान कृष्ण एकले ईश्वर अद्वितीय नंदात्मज रसिक शेखर स्वयं भगवान कृष्ण एकले ईश्वर अद्वितीय नंदात्मज रसिक शेखर भगवान कृष्ण कृष्णस्तु भगवान स्वयं व्हाटएवर कविराज गोस्वामी स्पीकिंग नॉट आउट ऑफ हिज ओन म्यूजिकल वे व्हाटएवर इज स्पीकिंग इज फॉलोइंग द परंपरा सिस्टम दैट इज वैष्णविज्म और आचार्य आचार्यमान पुरुष वेद स्टॉप दिस अनलेस यू एक्सेप्ट द आचार्य इन द परंपरा सिस्टम वी कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड थिंग्स एज दे आर इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल So Kaviraj Goswami is describing this Chaitanya Charitamrita strictly according to the verdict of the Shastras. His statement is that Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. Sang Bhagavan Krishna. Bhagavan is person. Bhagavan is not impersonal. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavan iti sabdat. First realization of the absolute truth by speculative knowledge is impersonal effulgence of the Lord, which is called Brahma Jyoti. Then Next realization is Paramatma, the localized aspect of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But realization of Krishna, that is the ultimate realization. Sang Bhagavan Krishna. Bhagavan means six opulences. Nobody is richer than Bhagavan. Nobody is stronger than Bhagavan. Nobody is more beautiful than Bhagavan. Nobody is wiser than Bhagavan. And nobody is more renouncer than Bhagavan. That is Bhagavan. Aishajyasya samagrasya bijasya jasasya sriya. That is Bhagavan. Sang Bhagavan means he is opulent, saraisajya purna, not partially. He knows everything. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, vedaham samiti itani. He knows past, present and future. He says therefore that all this, my dear Arjuna, yourself, myself, and all these soldiers and kings who have assembled here, it is not that we were not existing before. We are existing at the present moment also, and in future also we shall continue to exist. And how we shall exist? Individually. Otherwise Krishna would have said that in future, when we become liberated, then we shall become one. No. He says in future also, we shall continue to exist like this. You are individual, you are Arjuna, I am Krishna and all other living in. That is real understanding. Every one of us, living entities, we are all individual person. And Krishna is also individual person. This is knowledge. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam eko jubahunam vidadati kaman. Krishna or God, he is also nitya, eternal. We are also nitya, eternal. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We do not die. That is the preliminary knowledge of spiritual understanding, that I am not this body. I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. But I am individual. Nitya nityana. Krishna is individual person, I am also individual person. When Krishna says that sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja, it does not mean that I become one with Krishna or merge into the existence of Krishna. I keep my individuality. Krishna keeps his individuality. But I agree to abide by his order. Therefore, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna that I have spoken to you everything. Now, what is your decision? Individual. It is not that Krishna is forcing Arjuna. Jathechasi tathakuru. Now, whatever you like, and do. That is individual. This is the ultimate knowledge that this Mahabharata philosophy, that to become one, merge into the existence. Merge into the existence means we merge into the order of Krishna. Our individuality at the present moment is Maya because we are planning so many things. Therefore, your individuality and my individuality clashes. But when there will no more clashing, we shall agree. Central point is Krishna. That is oneness. Not that we lose our individuality. So, as it is stated in all Vedic literature and spoken by Krishna, we are all individual. All individual, Swayam Bhagavan, ekale Ishwar. But the difference is that he is the supreme ruler, Ishwar. Ishwar means ruler. Actually, he is ruler. And we are also ruler, but we are subordinate ruler. Therefore, he is equally Ishwar, one ruler. Ishwara Parama Krishna. In the Brahma Sangha. Equally Ishwar. Ishwar cannot be many. That is not Ishwar. The Mahabharata philosophy is that everyone is God. That is not very right conclusion. That is Raskaldam, Krishna says, Mura. Navang Prabhadante Mura. One who does not submit to the Supreme Ishara, the Supreme Lord, you should know it perfectly well that here is a Mura, rascal. Because it is not that everyone we can become Ishara. That is not possible. There is no meaning of Ishara. Ishara means the ruler. Suppose we are in a group. This is our international society. If everyone becomes ruler or acharya, then how it can be managed? No. There must be some head. That is the principle in our practical life. We follow our political leaders. We cannot say that I belong to this party unless I follow a leader. That is natural. So, that is the Vedic statement. Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. There must be one leader. The leader of the same quality, nitya. I am nitya, Krishna is nitya. Krishna is also living entity. I am also living entity. Nitya nityana, chetana chetanana. So, what is the difference between Krishna and me? The difference is that there are two nityas, or two chetanas. One is described as singular number and the other is described as plural number. Nitya nityanam. This nityanam is plural number. And nitya is singular number. So, God is nitya, one, singular number. And we are being ruled, we are plural number. This is the difference. And how is ruling the plural number? Because ekojo bhunam vidudhati kaman, he is supplying all the necessities of life, of all this plural number. Therefore, he is Ishwara, he is Krishna, he is God. One who is provides all the necessities of life, he is Ishwara, he is Krishna, he is God. So we can very well understand that we are being maintained by Krishna, and why we should not be ruled by him. This is a fact. Now we can see in this country, in this village, Mayapur, there are so many food grains are going, but who is supplying? That is Krishna. It is not possible to grow these food grains in your factory. No, that is not possible. He is helping us. He has stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Annad Bhavanti Bhutani, unless you eat sufficiently, unless you have food grains in stock, you cannot flourish. Bhutani, Bhutani. Bhavanti, Bhavanti means flourish. So both animals and men, they must eat sufficiently. There must be food grain sufficiently. So that food grain you cannot manufacture in your factory. You may start a very big factory, Goodyear tire factory. But that tire also will not move when there is no supply of petrol. This is your position. You are dependent even for this tire and petrol, and what to speak of this food grain. So who is supplying the food grain? The supplying person is eko jo bahunam vidhati kaman. That singular number, individual person, he is supplying. You can say prakriti, nature is supplying. No, nature is not supplying. Nature is the agent of supply. Real supplier is Krishna. Eko jo bahunam vidhati kaman. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Mayadhakshena prakriti suyate sacharachana. Nature is working under the instruction or the indication of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. In Brahma Sangita also it is stated, Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana shakti reka chayiva jasya bhuvanani vibharti durga. Yes, it is vibharti and vibhavanti. So, nature is dependent. Although nature has got this power, very extensive power, srishti sthiti pralaya, to create, to maintain, and to annihilate, such power nature has got. And therefore she is called Durga, Durga Devi. In Bengal there is great pompous Durga Puja. That is nature's worship. So, but nature is jasya agnaya. She is working under the order of Krishna. We Vaishnava, it is not that we do not care for Durga Devi. Somebody they say like that. No, we offer our all respect. Because she is the agent of Krishna. But we do not accept foolishly that Durga is all in all. No, that we do not accept. Durga is the agent, working agent of Krishna. Jashagya. Srishti sthiti pralaya sadhana shakti reka chayiva jasya bhuvanani vibharti durga ichchanu rupamapi jasya cha cheshtate sha. Sa cheshtate jasya ichchanu rupam. And Krishna also confirms this. Maya dhakshena prakriti swate sa charasa. Therefore, Krishna is the supreme Ishvara, controller. She is conducting the activities of the material nature. But those who are mudas, they are captivated by the wonderful action of material nature. That is called materialist. Tribhi gunamai bhavai mohita. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. They are bewildered. Nature business is to keep you full, always. And if you can surpass the bewilderment of material nature, if you agree to be controlled by the Supreme Controller, then your life is successful. Therefore, Chaitanya Charitamrita author says that here is the controller, Ekala, one. And Krishna also says, Mamekam. Not that imitation Krishna. Then you will be before. Mamekam. Sarang bhaja. So all the verdict of the Shastra is the same. It is simply our misfortune that we do not understand the verdict of the Shastra. In the Shastra, everything is there. So, Krishna is the Supreme Lord. That is the verdict of the Shastra. In the Brahma Sangita, it is in Bhagavata also say, Ite changsa kalapungsa krishnastu bhagavan sayam indrari bakulang lokang mrayanti yuge yuge. So try to understand. And Krishna says, matta parataram nanyo. No more supiga. Don't misunderstand that there is something superior to Krishna. That is rascal. So long we shall remain such a rascal, we shall not surrender to Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, Namang prapadyante duskritinam murha. Namang duskritinam murha prapadyante narada. Prapadyante, who does not surrender to Krishna? He'll say that there are so many big, big persons and they do not surrender to Krishna. So they are all murhas? Yes, they are all murhas. That is the verdict of the Shastra. We cannot make any compromise. That is not possible against the principle of the Shastra. If we keep one competitor of Krishna, then we are mura. Here it is said, Aditya. Not that there is another Krishna, Dhini Krishna. No. There cannot be any competitor of Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, Matta Parataram Nanya. There is no more anyone bigger authority than me. And here is also Chaitanya Charitamrita Kaviraj Goswami says, Aditya. No competitor, sir. Here we are all gods. They rascal down. Then everyone is God. But there is competition of gods. But in case of Krishna, there is no such possibility. No competition. Nobody can compete with Krishna. When Krishna was present, he showed it by practical example. Nobody could compete him in either knowledge, either strength, or love affairs, or any field of activities. There was no competition. Now Krishna, when was present, he married 16,000 wives. Where is competition? One cannot marry even 16 wives. And he becomes God. Just see the foolishness. Even from materialistic view, who is that God who can marry 16,000 wives? Is there any God, so-called rascal God? Is there any possibility? Krishna saw. Yes. Krishna was attempted to be killed from the very childhood, when he was 3 months old, by Putana. But he killed the Putana Rakshasi. Not he was killed. Similarly, Avasur, Bakasur, this Asur, that Asur, simply from the beginning of his life. Last, Kongsa and others, from the rogues, the Asuras, they were making plan to kill Krishna as soon as he is born. Kongsa. He was planning that as soon as Krishna is born, he was trying to kill Krishna's mother, Devaki. But with the argument of Vasudev, that don't do this. Your sister's son will kill you. But your sister will not kill. So let this son be born, I shall bring it to you. Kansa believed the honorable words of Vasudev because he knew that Vasudev is a very respectable, honorable man. He has promised that the child will be brought to me. So he saved his sister. He was such a cruel. The rogues and cruel, they do not care even for mother and sister. They can kill anyone. You see? That is the roguism. So Kansa was that type of rogue. But Vasudeva, by his intelligence, saved the situation. But as honorable person, he brought all the children to Kansa. You know this history. So the Kansa, or the Asura's plan is how to kill Krishna or God. That is going on. Everyone, God is dead. God is dead. When I first went to your country, the philosophy was that God is dead. But they admitted, no, God is living. Swamiji has brought in Sankirtan. That also they admitted. Yes. So God cannot be dead. If we are not ever dead, Na hannate hannamane sarire. How God can be dead? That is another foolishness. God cannot be dead. Nitya, that there is no meaning of nitya. So, this is the position of Krishna. He is the supreme person, supreme ruler, without any competitor. Aditya, no competition. Here we have got competition. But with Krishna there is no competition. There cannot be any competition. You cannot say that Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma or any other demigods, they are also as good as Krishna equally. No, that is not possible. Then he would not have used this word, Aditya. There cannot be any competition. If somebody puts any competitor before Krishna, he is a Pashandi. Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Daivati. Samatena Vikheta Sa Pashandi Bhaved Dhruvam. Narayan, the Supreme Person, if one compares with Narayan, with such exalted demigods like Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma, Brahma Rudradi Daivati. What to speak of other Indra Chandra? They are nothing in comparison to Brahma. Brahma is the creator of this universe. See, even such creator, even so powerful demigod as Lord Shiva cannot be compared with Krishna or Aditi. Cannot be compared. That is Pashandi. So Pashandi Bhavidruva. So those who are comparing all the demigods and Krishna, they are on the same level. You can worship anyone. They are all rascals. Because here it is said, Aditya, Krishna cannot be compared with anyone else. That is Krishna, Ishara, Parama Krishna. They may be Ishara. Lord Shiva may be Ishara. Lord Brahma may be Ishara. But they cannot be Parama Ishara. That is not possible. Parameshara is Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna. So, but at the same time, Nandatmaja or Vasudevatmaja, that is Krishna's mercy. That is dealing between his devotee and himself. Although nobody can become Krishna's father because he is the original father, Aham Adidhi Devanam. But he agrees to become the son of his devotee. This is called devotional dealing. Shanta Dasa Sakha Vatsala Rasa. This is a dealing of Vatsala Rasa. The father, nobody can become father of Krishna. That is not possible. He is the father. Aham Bija Padapita. He is the original father. But how Nandatmaja, how Nanda Maharaj can become the father of Krishna? No. That father means he wanted to become the best servant of Krishna. When I become father of my child, I am the best servant of the child. Actually. You see the children moving out. The mother is taking care. So the mother is the best servant of the child. So this is Vaishnava philosophy. They want to become one with the God. But we keep ourselves always servant of God. And to become the best servant of God is also to become his father and mother. This is Nandatma. Therefore, one devotee prayed, Aham Yangsi Nandanga Bande Jashalinde Parabrahma. Sutimapare, Sitimapare. The devotee is praying that somebody is studying the Vedas, somebody is studying the Puranas, the Smritis. Sutimapare, Smritimapare. And somebody is studying Mahabharata to understand God. But the devotee says, I do not want to understand God. I want to worship Nanda Maharaj under his, in the courtyard of his house. The Parabrahma is crawling. That is Nandatma. That is the, superior position of Nandatma, Nanda Maharaj. So, this is philosophy an ordinary man cannot understand, but Vaishnava philosophy is so nice that instead of becoming one with the Supreme, they want to become the father of the Supreme. This is Vaishnava philosophy, Nandatma. Rosika Sekha, this is also a pleasure. Krishna wants to be subordinate to his devotee as son, so that he may be punished. He is punishing everyone, but he wants to be punished also. That is his pleasure. And who will punish him? His father and mother, or superior lover, Radharani, can punish him. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is very scientific and sublime. Try to understand. Always read the books. Don't try to understand Krishna ordinarily. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaya jatatam visiddhyanam kaschid vetimam tattata. To understand Krishna is not so easy. But if you follow the Mahajan, if you try to understand the philosophy through the parampara system, then you will realize Krishna and your life will be successful. Thank you very much.